got some. So yeah.
I know y'all can't see my face. I'm trying to get ready real quick. I'm getting ready to leave. Me and my son are getting ready to go to this program. It's like a class or whatever. Yeah, I think I'm losing weight. And I'm just so excited about that. I really think it. The class today. We talked about just a lot of like icebreakers and getting to know everybody in the class. It's all about just women, just helping them to just be better parents. And I feel like that's something that's necessary. I want to take every opportunity that I can to be a better parent to my child. It was a very positive vibe. I loved it. Right now I'm back at home and take a nice bubble bath because child, these cramps is like, oh my God. I done lit me some candles, honey, and I'm about to just go and relax because, baby, Satan himself constructed these cramps that I'm having right now. I mean, my stomach is being in my intestines and my back and my hoo-ha, is everything is contracting and child, it just feels like hell on earth. Jesus, do you hear me? Can you help me out? Jesus be some idol, some pampering, relief. Order and divine purpose and divine connections, meaning that I don't ever feel like it's a coincidence or that you just bump into people. God strategically places people in your life to serve a specific purpose. God is very specific, and nothing is just gonna happen just because. People that you come in contact with are in your life for a reason, and it is really up to us to pay attention, use discernment, and kind of figure out what role that person is gonna play in your life. It's people that get married to people they were only supposed to go to Starbucks with that one day and learn something in that conversation that they have and move on and take that conversation to the next level versus spending your life with that person. And I think as you get older and you grow and you mature in Christ and just in life in general, you kind of get better at, or should get better with, picking and choosing who you have in your life, in your circle, and who you allow, what energy you allow around you. And a lot of positivity today, and I'm so grateful for that. And I got a lot out of the conversations. I was able to talk about a lot of things and release a lot of things. And as you all know, I'm a big, you know, advocate for that, like speaking on your truth and, you know, tell as many people as you can your story. Each time gets easier. Each time just it's you know, it's just easier to talk about and to release, and you feel a little bit better. And you know, I'm thankful for the experience, and I pray that God just uses me and uses these women to help me get to the next level of my life. And while I'm in transition once again, trying to you know, just push through like I always do, and just make it to the next level, and so that I could be the best mom that I can be, the best that I can be. I don't want to compare or compete with anybody. You know, my only competition is my old self, the person I was yesterday. You know what I'm saying? And I just want y'all to take that with you. Just strategically pick and choose who you have in your life, because it could be life or death for you, spiritually, mentally, financially, physically, everything, like emotionally. It can be life or death. So that's all I want to say. It's not a coincidence, the people that you have in your life. And if they are meant to stay, cherish them. And if they are not meant to be in your life, release them so that they can go forth and do what they are called to do. And that's it. I got deep on y'all, and I'm gonna take my bubble bath coat. My stomach is still hurting.